Hello, Bee here, and welcome back to Environmental Science. Humans have interacted with and used the environment for hundreds of thousands of years. However, how humans have interacted with and used the environment has changed drastically in that time. Starting as hunter-gatherers, then shifting to an agricultural society, followed by the Industrial Revolution, and finally to our modern society, the relationship between humans and the environment is one for the ages. Before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to discuss the effect humans have had on the environment throughout history. For most of human history, human beings lived in small, close-knit, nomadic tribes as hunter-gatherers. These tribes roamed from place to place, hunting animals for meat and foraging plants for food. Hunter-gatherers often respected the animals they were hunting and recognized the value of all of the parts of the animals they hunted. The communities would use the blubber from whales for warmth or lantern oil, the hide of cattle for clothing, and all parts of the plants in their diet. Although you may picture these societies living in balance with the environment, this lifestyle was not without its environmental consequences. Scientists have found evidence of many large mammals from over 10,000 years ago that went extinct. The common theory is that these large animals, like the saber-toothed cats and giant bison, were overhunted by the hunter-gatherers, causing their extinction. Around 10,000 years ago, the hunter-gatherers started to settle into long-term communities. They discovered the benefits of agriculture, farming, and larger communities. Agriculture is the act of growing food and raising animals for food and other human uses. The consequences, both good and bad, from this new domesticated lifestyle were far-reaching. The population of the Earth began to rise, and the effect of humans on the environment was more concentrated. During this time, humans learned selective breeding, meaning they figured out how they could breed crops for more desirable varieties, such as larger corn kernels, sweeter fruit, and longer, softer wool in sheep. It was during this time period that humans also discovered the benefits of crop rotations to help keep the soil fertile. Unfortunately, once again, human activity slowly started to have negative impacts on the environment. Over time, communities started destroying more and more wild land to use for agricultural practices, and in time, caused soil erosion, water shortages, and floods. There is a commonly accepted theory that while humans have used the environment in both positive and negative ways for hundreds of thousands of years, it is really within the last 300 to 400 years that we have done the most damage. As we entered the 1700s and 1800s, there was a large boom in inventions such as the light bulb, factory machinery, steam engines, and medicine. This time period is known as the Industrial Revolution. As humans learned to harness these inventions in ways that made life more efficient and allowed humans to have longer lifespans, unfortunately, many of these inventions utilized the power of fossil fuels, causing widespread damage to the environment. Similarly to the rest of human history, the Industrial Revolution and its innovative changes came at a cost. This was the time when air pollution started to affect the lives of people, animals, and plants, with soot from factories filling the air. There was also an increase in respiratory issues in populations due to the particulates from coal plants in the air. Disease was more rampant in cities due to overcrowding, and there was a loss of natural habitat from the expansion of cities even farther into the countryside. This revolution was not all bad, however. Due to the increase of efficiency and new medical breakthroughs, people were able to live longer lives. It is at this point that we start to see a real boom in the human population that has continued to today. During this time, while humans were being harder than ever on the environment, they were also learning how to utilize it for the good of species, even if the gain was only in the immediate use. Towards the end of the 19th century, philosophers started to change their view of the relationship between humans and the environment. During this time, philosophers came up with the theory of spaceship Earth. In this theory, philosophers and scientists view the planet Earth as one large spaceship. Like spaceships, Earth is a closed system. With the exception of the energy from the sun and the heat from the Earth, nothing comes in and out of the Earth. This means humans are unable to get rid of waste or attain more resources. Everything is finite. This idea goes on to discuss environmental problems on three levels: local, such as where to build a landfill; regional, such as a polluted river affecting drinking water in populations hundreds of miles away; and global, such as the depletion of the ozone layer. As we went through the lesson today, we learned about the history of the human impact on the environment, and that while there have been some positive impacts, there have also been some negative impacts. Humans and the Earth have had a give-and-take relationship for hundreds of thousands of years, and this relationship continues to change and adapt, even today. Until next time, remember, you're a force of nature. So keep sparking the changes that you want to see. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.